KATC Weather Lab. Here's Eric's forecast.
If you were outside today, the biggest thing you probably noticed it was not as humid. We finally got rid of that tropical moisture that had been with us over the past couple days through that tropical wave that brought the showers on Monday. So although it was still warm this afternoon, getting into the upper 80s, we didn't have to deal with that humidity. And that's going to mean good news for overnight lows as we go throughout the coming days. And the other big story today is the newest developments in the tropics. We'll take a look at that in just a little bit. But right now on the big picture, you can see we have some showers moving through Oklahoma back into Missouri. But the good news is that moisture is going to stay up to the north thanks to a high pressure that's developing over the east coast that's helping to push that moisture up to the north, so we won't have to worry about that. But this is producing some pretty strong easterly winds across the region, helping to dry us out as we went throughout. That's why we saw more sunshine today, but it's also causing some coastal flooding problems as coastal flood advisories continue as tides will continue to be 1 to 2 feet above normal as we go through the overnight hours. But winds should begin to back up a little bit as we go throughout tomorrow, and that should expire come about 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. Taking a closer look back at home, we can see woke up to bright blue sunny skies, then some clouds began to develop during the afternoon, and we still have some clouds around as we push into the evening hours. But I expect once the sun goes down, most of that cloud cover should begin to break apart, and it'll turn into a very pleasant evening across the region. Temperatures will fall back into the 70s and eventually make their way into the mid 60s by tomorrow morning, so it will be a little bit on the cool side as we get started for our Thursday. We're watching a couple of tropical waves. We have one just to the north of Cuba that's producing some showers on the eastern coast of Florida as we go throughout this afternoon. But you can see that convection, not really expecting much with this. It'll move into the Gulf of Mexico and then run into the shear. That's helping to keep the Gulf of Mexico right now all quiet. But as we move farther down into the Caribbean Sea, you can see this counterclockwise spin that's developing just off a shore of Nicaragua. That is now Tropical Depression 16. But you can see things are still relatively unorganized. But as we go throughout the coming days, this is expected to move over some more favorable conditions and then get its act together as we go throughout the weekend and maybe even become a hurricane. But right now, Tropical Depression 16 has winds at 35 miles per hour, moving off to the north northwest at 7. So it will interact with Nicaragua and Honduras as we go throughout tomorrow. But you can see it is expected to become Tropical Storm Nate later tonight or through the overnight hours, strengthening up to around 40-45 mile per hour winds as it moves over Central America tomorrow afternoon. Tropical storm warnings are in effect for those region. Not really looking at the winds to do a lot of damage, but heavy rain could cause some flash flooding and mudslides as we go throughout tomorrow. By Friday, the storm's back into the Caribbean Sea and strengthening, as you can see, up to around 70 miles per hour by Friday afternoon, then making a close pass by the Yucatan Peninsula, getting into the Gulf of Mexico this weekend, quickly becoming a hurricane, as you can see, by Saturday afternoon, but a low-level Category 1 at that, 85 mile per hour winds. And then it's expected to turn off to the north northeast, make landfall around the Florida Panhandle by Sunday afternoon, and then beginning the weekend once it moves onshore as it moves back through Georgia and up towards the Carolinas. And taking a look at our European model, this kind of shows it out really well. You can see that weak system right now just off the coast of Nicaragua. As we go throughout the next 24 hours, moves right over shore, gets back over the waters, and then makes its way right between the pass between the Yucatan and Cuba as we head into Friday afternoon. Then as it makes its way into the Gulf of Mexico, you can really start to see it firing up, becoming that hurricane by Saturday afternoon. And then as we go into Sunday, that's when we expect it to make its way to the east. And that's all because we'll have this troughal system making its way down in across our region, helping to steer that system away from us and pushing it over towards Florida as we go into Sunday, expecting Sunday landfall late Sunday afternoon and then moving onshore as we go into Monday. But the saving grace for us as of right now looks to be this front. It should hopefully help to push that thing out to the east and cause no real issues here in Acadiana. Back closer to home, we can see a very comfortable night. Temperatures around 67 degrees by tomorrow morning. And then with plenty of sunshine, we'll make our way into the upper 80s. But thanks to that low humidity, it shouldn't feel too bad if you're outside tomorrow afternoon. So a pleasant evening in store. Cooler and less humid, dropping to a low of 66 degrees. And we also have that full harvest moon if you want to get out there and check that out this evening or early tomorrow morning. Bright blue sunny skies for our Thursday. Staying warm as we're in the upper 80s, around 89. But as I mentioned, due to lower dew points, it'll feel rather comfortable. Winds out of the northeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Staying dry on Friday, but as that system gets into the Gulf of Mexico, could send us that moisture, 40-60% chance of showers Saturday and Sunday, but staying warm even into Monday, still around 91 degrees with a slight chance for some rain. Front moves through on Tuesday, and that brings us that first wave of some fall-like air by the middle and end of next week. Highs in the low 80s, lows dropping down into the low 60s. Looking forward to that.
See, I wore my sweater tie and a cool front is on the way. It works. Still ahead here on Acadiana's News Channel tonight at 6 o'clock.